Nityanandam. This is Sunita from Hyderabad. I'm here in this ashram for the first time. I've just been seeing Swamiji's videos on internet and somehow heard about Nitya Yoga Teachers Training, and something pulled me here. Just a night before, and the program starts on 2nd, and till 31st night I didn't know I'm going. And something happened, Ma called me, and I just wanted to come here. And next day morning I booked my tickets, and here I am, landed in this ashram. It's been a beautiful experience. I didn't know what I'm going to do, how will it be. Everybody here is somehow, you know, they have been to this ashram or some of the programs of Swamiji. I was literally, you know, totally untouched to this place, to this culture. So initially I was inhibitant, you know, what's going to happen. But then it has been an amazing journey of all these 4 days. I've been always wanting to learn yoga, and the asking was to learn yoga from an authentic place, authentic yoga from our traditions. And I think one of the best places that I've found is here. I'm so thankful to be here. I'm thankful to myself for landing here, thankful to this place for calling me here. And not only these things, I saw videos of Swamiji, you know, listen to his satsangs, and somewhere there's so much of validation of the path that I'm going. You know, listening to an enlightened being, you know, okay, there are a few things that I'm doing, I know, okay, I'm on a right path. And there are many things which I'm seeking for years altogether, and there's so many answers that I got kind of, you know, in a bunch all together. I've been looking for Hindu traditions, I've been looking for, you know, magical experiences and so many things all together, and everything is there in one place. I'm so thankful to all the people over here. I've been welcomed by all of them beautifully, and I have looking forward to the next more days and wanting to join the Nitya Kriya which is coming up. And let's see what's on for me over here. Thank you so much.
Like how in the story of Krishna, when Lord Krishna, he goes to his devotee, very old lady, she never gets attached to any such thing. And all that, she's very strong devotee, but she has this one cow, she's very attached to it, she'll never leave it, she's so careful of it and all that. So one day when Lord Krishna goes to see her, he sees the cow and he sees her and he stays and he speaks with her and all that. And then Arjuna also goes along with him. So after some time the cow dies. So then she starts crying and all that. Then and she's a very poor lady, so when she gave Krishna all the food, she became much more poor. So because to feed him, so then the only cow was the only source of her life. So then after the cow died, then Arjuna asked Krishna, why did you make that cow die, and now she's your devotee, she gave you so much of food, she was so devoted to you, why did you take the only source of her life, the cow, from her? Then Krishna says, she did not have attachment to anything else, only this cow was only attachment. So just to remove that attachment, I took away that cow from her so that she gets finally liberated. So what I feel is, if you listen to the master's words and do whatever the master says, naturally you'll get out from this attachment, and he will make sure that you're out from attachment.
Just adding a point, what I also feel is like how in Gurukul we wear basma all the time, vibhuti. So Swamiji said the context why we even wear that is just to remind us that one day everything will become ash. So when you realize that, you really won't get attached to anything, because you know that you've come down just to enjoy and discover your consciousness and not to get incomplete. So when we wear that and just remind ourselves, then I don't think we'll get attached.
What I feel is like whatever you are attached to the most, Kalibra just takes away from you immediately. So what I feel is like when you just experience that one moment where that something which you're completely attached to, like it just goes away from you, then you'll just like be in that incompletion for some time. But then later on you'll understand that whatever is there with you is of no use, and you'll understand that Kalibra is just doing his duty and just bringing you to the space of completion. So what I feel is like after you experience this, after you get this anubhuti, what I feel is like you'll never have the incompletion to lose anything again.